Hello, my name is Vira Egzsár from Hate for Research Institute. I'm the coordinator of the project formation. I have been working with EU-funded research, innovation and education project for more than 12 years now. Having realized that I'm belonging to a group of professionals working throughout Europe as research managers, I started to put more and more efforts to professionalize the work of my team and also to contribute to the professionalization of existing but so far hardly recognized profession. Similarly, to many, many colleagues based in different countries of Europe, I'm passionate about my job. Why? I love to learn continuously, I love to get to know and work with different people from different countries. I love to support the development of innovative services, methodologies, technologies, products through joint work. Since my office, we are engaged in all possible phases of research management and administration. In the recent years, we gathered quite some experience that I would love to share with you. However, now focus on Module 2, Lesson 4, preparation of the project proposal. First and foremost, it must be said that it takes time and it takes a lot of resources. Depending on the funding frame and program, you shall dedicate at least 3, but in many cases 6 months to prepare a project proposal as a coordinator. As you might have already learned, RMAs can have very diverse role also in the preparation of the project proposal. So you can just review what your research colleagues have written, but you can get more involved by keeping touch with the partnership, doing the budget, or in some cases it also happens that RMAs do carry out the majority of the work. How to do so? First and foremost, you have to formulate a story and you have to point out what will be the innovation in your project, how will you overcome the current state of the art of the given field, and what will be the change that your project will result in. To do so, you have to define your goals and the expected impact. And this is the top level that your project wish to achieve, and then you can divide this downward. So then you have to identify what will be the outcomes, what will be the outputs of your project, and then the concrete activities. Then you have to organize the activities to different work packages within your work plan, within the given timeline of a project. Once you have a well-defined work plan, you can get a very clear picture what kind of expertise, technologies, infrastructure, facilities, know-how and whatever is needed for the successful implementation of your project. And this is the phase when you can start to build up your consortium and look for partners. In many cases, it's great if you have already a good network through Europe, but for each and every topic, you have to check who are the most relevant partners, who were previous beneficiaries of funded projects, who are members of Europe-wide networks, umbrella organizations. So who are those who are really needed for your project proposal? To reach out the partners and to engage them successfully, we generally develop a very nice project concept, which makes your project appealing. Then, once you have a partnership, then you can decide how you organize the work within. You can do everything as a coordinator and do the work totally in a centralized manner, but it is also possible that you divide the work and you decentralize the work by relying on the expertise and the motivation of your partners. But for any case, it is very important to have a common understanding of the goals, of the desired impact, the necessary activities within all members who are working on the project proposal. When you are getting closer to the end of the proposal preparation phase, It is very highly suggested, based on our experiences, to have an external reviewer, a kind of pre-evaluator, a person who was not involved in the preparation phase and who can review it with fresh eyes. It is not necessary to have it as a totally external person. It can be a member of your group who was not involved yet. Another important issue, if it is possible, to include as many, of course, relevant illustrations, graphs, and graphics as possible. And for that, it's also good if you have a graphic designer. As regards the first draft of the whole proposal, I suggest it to have it at least 2 weeks before the deadline. Sometimes it seems impossible, but it is very important because even within these 2 weeks, there will be a lot of work, so with fine-tuning, with improving different parts, but still, you will have something in your hands that can be submitted at any time. And as regards the submission, never ever target to submit the proposal at the deadline, at the day of the deadline, because all the online platform systems generally crash down. And if your work just go to waste because you cannot submit your proposal, it is very uncomfortable. Lastly, my message to future RMEs. I would say that if you are keen to work in multicultural environment, if you want to get to know cultures, different research fields, topics, if you want to learn continuously, and if you are able to do multitasking, manage your time, and to make a difference with your job, then becoming a research manager is perhaps the best choice for you. Thank you very much for watching this video. Do not forget to register to our online learning subpage of the formation website and also sign up for the project's mailing list not to miss any of the upcoming events and highlights. Goodbye!